Hello, can you hear me on this? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Wherever place you hear from, glad you can hear me. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you. I missed you guys. I was gone Tuesday and Sunday because I didn't astray now. I was at some conventions. Had a good time. My name is Joey. I'm the pastor here. I welcome all of you here. We're all believers of what? Jesus Christ? Right, amen. And we're fellowships of what? Deaf and hearing believers together. We're a team, we're a body of Christ, so we're all together to glorify His kingdom. Now, you know what time it is? Toll time. Do you remember that TV show? I missed that show. Jim Allen was a cool guy. It's time for announcements. All right. As you see on the announcement paper, the big mistake, it says June 6th. Really supposed to say June 4th. Today at the church. Whose fault? My wife. Rarely she makes mistakes. It tends to be me. Congratulations on the fumes. After church, members will pass out the minutes, the last board meeting. You have to go over it and approve it. And they're ready for next year. We keep it simple. Tuesday night, we have Bible study at 7 a.m. in the morning. I'm glad you're paying attention. P.m. I know we work. So p.m., nighttime. So come and join us, learn about purpose-driven life. What's your purpose for God? If you don't know, come join us. You can learn His purpose for you. Understand? We all have a purpose ourselves, sometimes we think, but if you want the best purpose, it's His way. So come and learn, join us. June 11th. Next week after church, we have fellowship. We'll go somewhere and eat. We haven't decided yet, so we're going to discuss after church where you want to go. If you want to go to McDonald's, that's fine with me. The kids, of course, like, yay! Yeah. So you have some ideas? You got any? Soup? Plantation? Is that right? If you hometown buffet, going to Corral, there's a few options to discuss. As we know, we went to the state rally in Riverside, and we tried to bid for the state rally for the next 2 years. Unfortunately, we lost. Someone beat us. But that's all right. We won 2021. So we will host the state rally here 2021. So we have 4 years to plan to make it great for him. So we're going to need lots of prayers, lots of hands to work to make everything great. It'll be fun. So be ready to be involved. So we have 4 years to plan. A lot of planning. We'll make it fun. Oh, yeah. Do you guys know who Chris and Lorella Cruz? Do you remember them? Pastor Fred and Pastor Linda, the pastor before me, the granddaughter, the little, we're really this big now, Leslie and Carter. They're this big now. I remember when they were little tiny. My wife used to take care of them. They're like little. They're going on a missions trip. In Nicaragua, I can't even say it right, sorry. Nicaragua. Nicaragua. So they're going to the end of June. So if you would like to support them, write on the paper, listing Carter's mission trip. It will set money to support them. And Royal Camp still going on? When's the last day you get the money for the world? 18? Okay, 18. We still have 2 more weeks left. So this week, if you're going to give Royal Kids Camp, write it on the paper. The offering slip. Offering slip. You can tell maybe I'm a little bit tired. I'll tell you why. So if you'd like to support these 2 missions, write it down. Royal Kids Camp and Cruise Missionary Trip. Birthday announcement. Sarah. Her birthday's on the 24th. Sarah's not here. 24th. Joey, I don't know who that loser is, on the 20th. Oh, wait a minute, that's me. My birthday's on the 20th. So I'll take iTunes gift card. No, I'm just kidding. I don't care. Omar, birthday's on the 26th. Noemi, the A. Ooh, that's soon. That's 24 days. We celebrate birthday on Tuesday. Alan, the 16th. Yeah. So happy birthday. Happy belated birthday. Happy early birthday, whatever. And happy unbirthday to those who don't have a birthday. You said something else? Oh, important. Oh, yeah. June 10th. On June 10th, as we know, one of our members is moving, so they need help cleaning up the house to move on June 10th. Meet with Omar at the church and Jamie for more details on helping on moving on June 10th, this Saturday. So don't make plans. So once prayer, we will pray after when I finish preaching. We have a special prayer time, okay? I think that's it for announcements. It's time for a run for funds. What's it for? We send kids to camp, which is very expensive. And we like to have the parents to relax from paying. So we as a church support, we have $1 bill. These kids run and collect the $1 bill. And we support the camp that we paid on. Are you ready? Get set. Hey, I haven't said go. Get ready. Get set. Get set number 2. Go. All right. As we know, one member always has the money coming. He's not here today. Thank you all for your support. Really appreciate it. I think we have enough to send who wants to go. Okay. Now it's time for tithe and offering. So you have the cards in front of you. We have the cards in front of you. Put down your name. If you want contact, you need prayer requests, put it down and we'll pray for you. And right here, you see that jug? It's kind of low. So I'd like to encourage us all to collect all our coins. Look in your car, behind your couch, your pocket, any corner, the water fountains, pick up the coins, whatever you can find, and put them in here to support BID, Bible Institute for the Deaf in the Philippines, that we send support for them. All right? Tithe and offering. Usher, Alan, and Beth. Come on up. Sorry. You have to tap me for me. And if you see a new face here, greet them. Introduce yourself, your name, who you are. Get ready, get set, go. Are you guys fine? Are you warm? Is it hot? You need a cool AC on? You're fine? I guess it's me on that light. I'm gonna melt. I'll turn the AC a little bit more soon. All right, let's pray for this. God of heaven, Lord, we thank you because of who you are, the love you have for us all, the awesome love that you provide for us as we give back to you. Lord, I pray for those who are in need, may touch and provide for them. Use us, Lord, as we're all willing to serve you, Lord. I thank you for who gave, those who could give. Lord, thank you for all you've done for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, there's some more right there. Now, are you ready to worship the Lord? Worship team, come on up. Wolfram, get one. Let me get a set of. Is it loud enough for you back there? You turn it up a little bit more. Turn up a little bit. The last. Testing one, testing two, testing three, testing four, testing five, testing six, testing seven, testing eight. Is that good? Excellent. Very good. Speak up louder. Recall one. Good. Ready to begin? As usual, I start with prayer. It's important. Father Heaven, Lord, I come before you, give myself to use me, Lord. And these here give themselves to you as well, Lord, so they can hear your words, to be transformed, your living words, which transforms every one of us here. Holy Spirit, you're invited here to work through us all. Fill us all so we can do your works and be filled to overflow. Not to only touch the people in the church, but the people on the outside as well. And we bring them to your kingdom, Lord. We thank you for all you've done for us. Thank you, Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's start with the comics. I always have comics in the beginning. Not Jonah sticks again. You know, kids are like, fish sticks. But Jonah sticks again. The prayer, stand on, lend your arm. Have you ever played in sports or you watch your favorite sports team? You're playing, let my team win. Come on. Yeah. I've done the same. I was praying for the Cowboys to win, to go in the Super Bowl. Texas people here, Cowboys. I'm a Cowboys fan. I guess I didn't pray hard enough. Better this year? It's a possibility. Like yesterday, I went to the Angels game. Yeah, do you know what happened yesterday? Pujols hit his 600 home run. And I was there to witness it. It was a exciting moment for me. 600 home runs, the ninth person in history to do that. It was a fun game. So I was praying, Lord, let me see it. I just bought these tickets to let it go to waste. Thank you for listening to my prayers, Lord. This guy needed the maximum Baptist package. The waterfall. Not satisfied, so the waterfall. So you're interested in getting baptized and you want the waterfall experience? Right now it's a good time because we have water right now. Over there. If the drought continues the next few years, there's going to be no waterfall. Take advantage of that package I offer. Recently, I went to the state rally in the South Cal Network Convention recently. It was really good. I learned a lot of things from them. The first they were talking about the most was this, Romans chapter 8, verse 37. Know in all things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. We conquer with him. He helps us conquer things in our lives. 2 weeks ago, I spoke about Goliath, the giant. I can't imagine. He was 9.5 feet tall. That's pretty tall. I'm only 5'10". So it'd be like this. Oh, my neck hurts. So, and I said, we face Goliaths in the life once in a while. We faced it on the very first day of accept Jesus Christ because Satan was working hard to offend you from accepting him. Boom, boom, boom. The day I accepted him, Satan tried to block me. Oh, he tried. But of course, God was victorious. Satan threw things in my life, Goliath, to block me. But God was victorious. So I defeated that giant. And it said King David defeated Goliath. He did. But did you know he had 5 brothers? 5 more giants. Really? If you read more in there, it says David and his people defeated those giants as well. I spoke about that. Again, read this verse again. Romans chapter 8, verse 37. No, in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. When we conquer, we do a lot more with him. We do great things for him. My subject today is after the fall. So we have King David who defeated the giant already. Great. Was that it? Was it finished? No. Continue. He conquered. He has to do more. He has to set up the kingdom. But he wasn't a king yet. So he had to progress. And he trusted in the Lord. And eventually he became the king. He done many great things. And he made some mistakes, as we know. Bathsheba. Bathsheba. Ouch. That was a giant where he fell. When you read about King David, you see he faces giants. Giants. He's victorious in some. He's not victorious in some. But for us all, we defeat the giant after the fall. Yes, I could just boom, boom, my lazy boy and relax. Watch all the baseball I can. And football coming up soon. Basketball's almost over. Go to stay. Go to stay, fans. Good. Some of you like the other team, that guy. Yeah. But that's all right. We're all in the body of Christ. We're all different. We work together. So after defeating the giant, we have to prepare ourselves to be ready for the next giant. Don't be foolish thinking, I'm finished. I accepted Jesus Christ. I'm finished. I defeated this giant in my life. I defeated that giant in my life. I'm finished. I'm just going to relax. No. The time we can relax is when we're up there with the Lord. We're still working for him. We're serving him because we love him. We want to bring people to the kingdom of God. We have people here that are already in the kingdom of God already. We work together as a body of Christ in unity so we can grow. That's good. But we need to reach those out there. Internally, it's good, internally. But externally, we need that as well. For the church to grow, the internally has to go on externally. That's how we serve the Lord. Second Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old is gone. The new is here now. We defeated the giant. We're a new creation. The old is gone. Your sinful past is gone. Doesn't matter what it was. You ask him to forgive you. He says, yes, I forgive you. But Lord, I did this, I did this, I did this, I did this, I did this. I'm on Santa's naughty list. All these sins. I asked the Lord to forgive me. He says, yes. He is faithful. He's willing to forgive you. And he's also willing to work with you to help you grow, to fight the giants that will happen in the future. You will meet those giants. So we have to set up a defense. How many of you were kids, you made a fort with your blankets, with your pillow? Yeah. Me and my daughters do that all the time. We make a fort. So she had like 10 sharks, stuffed animal sharks. So we put them on the ground. We have a mattress. We make a fort. We pretend the sharks are alive. Bad shark. Jaws, no, no. But if we get off of it, I'll be like, I'm dying. Because like, no, daddy. It's just fake, but it's imaginary. It's fun. We make a fort to prevent. Have you done that in your life? Have you set up forts in your life? Yes, good. I'm glad to see you. Yes. Amen. Good. We have to remember, he is a shield, a refuge, a strong tower. He helps us. Physically, we have weapons. I have one. It's a knife. It's a good weapon for defense. Against humans, a gun, you know, against humans. But you have to remember who we're fighting against who. Satan, you know, like that. The enemy is Satan. Satan, the enemy. It's spiritual. This is not going to do anything. Well, you call them the Ghostbusters, maybe. But unfortunately, they're not real. Ghostbusters don't exist. The movie Ghostbusters, the movies. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12 says, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but rulers against the authorities, the powers of the dark world, against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. That is who is fighting against you. That is your giant. They will appear. They will tempt you. Oh, I'm a pastor. I won't be tempted. I get tempted every day. You get tempted every day. Temptation is not the sin, but doing the temptation, accepting it and doing it is the sin. I'm going to put my knife away before I cut myself. Safety first. But when I'm fighting, I can't do nothing. But this is your weapon against the spiritual forces, the words. Jesus, when he was tempted in the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights, Satan came up and tempted him with three things. This rock, you're hungry, right? Let's turn it to bread. No, Man does not live by bread alone. Put him on the mountain. All this can't be yours if you worship me. He said, no, we only worship the Lord. There's one more. It's still in my mind. But he used the word against Satan. It was the word that was powerful, that canceled out everything Satan said. We know Satan's a liar, but he's a smart liar. He knows how to twist the words. He'll sometimes look at the words and say, oh, no, God says this. Remember Adam and Eve? Oh, surely you will not die. So he persuaded with words. But God told him directly, do not touch that tree. If Adam and Eve was like, the Lord told us, do not touch that tree. So that means what? Don't touch the tree. So be gone, you ugly little snake. Could have done that. But the flesh. Yeah. I know what I spoke about this before. The armor of God. I love this passage. You can look in your Bible, Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10, verse 18. 8 verses, 9, 8 verses, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 9 verses. Read that. Do you remember the whole verse? Do you remember what God provided for you? What are the parts of the armor? So are you ready to go on the first one? The belt of truth. The belt of truth. It's the first item. Now, the belt of truth. When I lied as a child, my dad got his belt and said, hey, you better tell me the truth, I'm going to whack you. So we told the truth. So you know that? The belt of truth. You snap it, tell the truth. No, the belt protects you. It keeps your pants up. Because when you're running and you don't have a belt and you can lose a lot of weight, it's going to fall down. You're going to fall on your face. It's going to hurt. The same thing. When you're not telling the truth, you're going to run, you're going to fall, hit your face. I told you, Satan is the father of lies. He will lie. To try to get you to sin against God. He doesn't want you with him. He's going to tell you many things. You sin. I know you sinned last night and you're in church. God's not going to love you. Satan will tell you that. Some people stop coming to church because they sin. Because Satan lied to them. But we know the truth. If you confess your sins to him, he is faithful. He'll forgive you. He will wipe it all out. We have to defend with truth. The Word of God has the truth how to live. His truth. His love. The world says many, many, many different things. People tell us different stories. Is that the truth? Is it against God? How can you know? This tells you the truth. All way leads to heaven. Is that true? All way leads to heaven? Anything? No? Good. How do you know? The Bible says it. John 14:6. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me, Jesus. There's the truth. So, So we have the truth here. When you use it, it protects you. It helps you. John chapter 8, verse 44. If you're living in a lie, you belong to your father, the devil, and you want to carry out his desires. He was the murderer since the beginning. Not holding on the truth. But there's no truth in Satan. There's no truth in him. When he lies, it's his native tongue. That's how he speaks. Lying is normal for him. For he is a liar, the father of lies. So Satan is a liar. He's not going to tell you the truth at all. He will deceive you. He wants to tear you from him, your relationship from him. That's his goal. John chapter 8, verse 32. Then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. When you read the word of God, the truth sets you free. Because you used to be in chains to sin, to sin. You're stuck. You feel trapped. Am I doomed to go to hell? Am I doomed to be separated from him? But someone came and shared his truth. And I accepted this truth. And my chains were broken. Same as your chains were broken. We're free, the burden, gone. The sins, all on me. That's all. They gave it to the Lord. So I learned he died on the cross. He was crucified. His blood washed my sins away. And the best thing, he was free. We know we say in life nothing is free. But that gift was free. True. But it was not free for Jesus. It cost him his life to give us a free gift. Jesus had to suffer so the truth can go out, so you can have the truth. So the truth sets you free. You're struggling with something you're not sure. Find it in the Bible. Pray to the Lord. He will set you free. The second, the breastplate of righteousness. It covers our important vital organs. A heart, a lungs, a liver. It protects them. With the police, they wear a vest because if they get shot, it protects them. Because they know it's important. Getting hit in the heart can kill you. Warriors, they wear the armor here to protect themselves. Same with us. We have to protect our heart. Because we always think, Jesus is down in my heart, right? Jesus is down in my heart. Our heart is where emotion is. So we need to protect that. We do get hurt in our lives. We mess up. The heart mourns. We have to remember that he loves us no matter what. And he is willing to forgive us. But when you have that protection on your heart, knowing he loves me no matter what, I'm protecting, 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 protecting. It guards our hearts. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Above all else, guard your heart. From everything you do from it flows from it. No. The point to protect your heart. When your heart stops beating, your body dies. The blood works through the heart. Your brain needs your heart. Your whole body needs your heart because the blood flow is life. He is the life that flows through you. But when you stop the heart with the Lord, life ceases. So I keep him. It's my 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 21. God has made him to be no sin, to be a sin for us. So that because of him, we become righteous in him. Because of Jesus, we are made righteous. How many of you never sinned before? Ooh, I didn't raise my hands because I've sinned before. Righteousness. How can I have righteousness? Jesus. He paid a price to make you righteous. And he covers you with his righteousness. Because when you face the Lord, when it's your time, you face the Lord, he's going to see the breastplate of righteousness because of Jesus Christ. I've seen you set my son, Jesus Christ, in our free gift. So well done, good and faithful servant. Yes. I know I can't earn my way into heaven. I can't myself. I need him. He helps me. He helps me live righteousness too. Before I was a Christian, most of us were bad people, bad boys, bad girls. But he leads us to change. Like I said earlier, we're a new creation. So we need to be new. We can't be living in the past. We have to throw away the past. As we go on, we grow. I'm expecting you, as we grow, to eliminate things that don't belong to him. But you have to be with him and depend on him. The footwear of peace and gospel. As we go out, we share the gospel to others. We are here because someone shared the gospel with us. Someone invited me to a youth group. Some of you had friends that told you about Jesus. Some of you passed out tracts, you know, those tracts. Some of you found the bathroom. Oh, hey. Some of you watched TV and got saved through TV. The gospel we share in the peace that we have through him. Life on earth, not very pretty sometimes, right? Things happen. Disasters happen. Sometimes it looks like the future is not looking good. We have terrorism happening. London, the other day, it happens. Are you worried? Whatever happens, I know I'm with the Lord. So I have the peace of knowing when it's my time, it's my time. I will be with him, so I have that peace. I'm not thinking every day, if I die, what's going to happen to me? What's going to happen? I'm not. Because I know that he is with me, and I will be with him if something happens to me. So I have that peace. 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 11. But you, man of God, flee from all this and pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and chance on this. we have the peace, but when we pursue these things, because we're peaceful. If you have strife in your life, conflicts, unforgiveness, you don't have peace. The word of the Lord says, forgive those, or he can't forgive you. It's pretty straightforward. Forgive those, because he has forgiven you for all you've done. And when you have conflict, it messes with your mind, your heart, and you don't have peace. Give it to the Lord, ask forgiveness, and move on, and you have peace. Jesus promised, John chapter 14, verse 27, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give you what the world gives you. Do not let your heart be troubled, and don't be afraid. He has given you peace for your souls. He promised that. Life on earth is short. But after we pass on, we have eternity in one of the two places, up there or down here. You're going up. Good. I'm going up. I have my Superman cape ready. Because of Jesus Christ. It's going to be fun. So I'm not troubled because Jesus promised. He promised that. I'm saying these things because when we defeat the giant, we need these things to help us defeat evil, spiritual things, defeat them. The shield of faith. The shield protects us. Boom, boom. Some of you probably seen the movie 300. And if you haven't, you can read the book, Wikipedia about it. So the story is about these group of 300 men with shields and spears. And Greece is ready to be taken over by the Persians. And there was thousands of these Persians. They had these little gates. And they need time to evacuate. How are they going to defend against this group? They have the shield. They have their faith that they can block them. Boom, 300 men defeated thousands of armies. Eventually, they lost later, but they protected the city. But God will continue defending you. His shield continues. Satan has 1/3 of the angels that went with him. They will attack you again and again and again. But when you have the shield, it's going to protect you. If you don't have the shield, boom, 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 it's going to continue hitting you. Boom, boom, boom. Ah, boom, 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 boom. So we have to use the shield when the giant comes. Second Timothy chapter 1, verse 1. This is why I'm suffering as I am. Yet, no cause for shame. Because I know who I believe and am convinced that he is able to guard what I have. Trust in him till that day. I have the shield of knowing I trust him with what? My soul, my salvation. I have that, and I trust him. And until the day, he will protect it. For Psalms chapter 28, verse 7. The Lord is my strength, my shield. My heart trusts in him, and he helps me. My heart leaps for joy, and I sink and I praise him. He is my strength and my shield. When bad things happen, boom, 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 I trust in him. The helmet of salvation. It protects your brain. That's another very important organ. Without it, you can't think. With our minds, we think about him. With our minds, we smell, we see, we hear. Well, some of us have here. But we hear with our eyes. So it works in a different way. We taste, we smell. Five senses. We use them. The helmet protects our thoughts. Satan uses our thoughts. Hey, check out that girl over there. No. Just one night is no big deal. Satan. Oh, stealing that is no big deal. Just one thing, it's small. Guard your minds. Yeah. Mr. Man. Guard your mind. But when you read his words, you're throwing out Bill. Boom, boom, boom. Fill in your mind with him. Verse Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16. For who has known the mind of the Lord as we instruct him? We have the mind of Christ. We accept him, the mind. The Holy Spirit moves in us so we understand his words. We read. We increase the mind. We need to learn who Jesus was and how he lived. The sword of the Spirit. Weapon. I've shown you before with my Jedi sword before, remember that? The Word of God is what changes us. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. For the Word of God is alive. It's alive. Some people may look at this paper, but no, it's really alive and active, sharper than any double edged sword. It penetrates, dividing the soul and the spirit, the joints and the marrows. It judges the thoughts and the attitude of the hearts. But when you feel convicted, the word is working in you. That's what helps you. Because when you feel bad, I remember the word says, speak towards people. When you sin, the Word of God. Sometimes you're clueless and you read and you find out, I've done something wrong. Boom. And we change. I hope you change. Improve your lives. The last one is prayer. 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 It's often forgotten part of the armor, but it's there. It's important in the armor, prayer. We get our strength from him. Pray for strength. He says, knock, knock, knock. He'll open the door. But the thing is, you have to knock. If you're not knocking, that can open the door. If someone wants a cup of sugar from my house, they have to come and knock and let me know. They're not going to sit in the house. Joey, I need some sugar. I'm going to be in my house doing my own thing. I'm not going to know. Unless they come and knock on the door. Yes, you have some sugar? Sure. There you go. Pray. 1 Thessalonians. Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 7. Simple and small. Pray continually. Pray continually. Don't stop praying. Keep praying. Constantly, constantly praying. Don't give up. Put on the full armor of God that you can stand against the devil's schemes. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11. So I recommend you read the whole passage again about the armor of God. You have your Bibles. You have your Bible. You have your phone. You have your iPads. You can read. You have your computer at home. You can read that. I want to tell you a story that really happened in history about someone defeating the giant. We know King David. He was not a king at that time, but he defeated Goliath. I put this date down. Do any of you know this date? May 14, 1948. No? No? Jewish? What about the Jewish? Group of Jewish defeated? The state of Israel was born. When Jesus was around, Israel was around. But after Jesus, Israel was crushed in 70 AD. Almost 2,000 years, they haven't come back. World War II, do you know what happened in World War II? 5 to 6 million Jews were exterminated. That's a lot. I would think hopeless. No chance, no hope. In 1945, that's when World War II was finished. But they decided to get together and set up a nation against all odds. And they became a nation again. The Bible prophesies that. The Lord comes near. And in 1967, have you heard of the Six-Day War? Yeah. The countries that surround it was defeat this little small nation. But it took Israel 6 days to defeat them. God is with them. The God's chosen people. God is with them. Impossible odds. But with God, nothing is impossible. You have to trust in Him. So you have to put on the full armor to be evil. Right now, there's about 8.5 million people living in Israel now. It's still a small country. But they're very prosperous. They have water. They have defense. It's hard to defeat them. People fear them. With God on their side, there's a prophecy later on they'll be attacked and they'll be victorious. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29. For God is a consuming fire. Sin comes. The giant comes. Lord, take care of it. And then you can make s'mores. S'mores? After it's burnt to a crisp. But you have to depend on Him. And don't slack off. Become lazy. Don't. Continue growing. Continue reading His Word. Continue praying. Pray continually. The armor of God. Leave it on. He said His burden is light. So the armor is heavy. But He makes it light for us. And we have to use it. Keep it on. You take it off, and China's gonna bow. be on the defense, be ready. Today is the day of Pentecost. I encourage you to read chapter Acts, chapter 2, the day of Pentecost, about the Holy Spirit. I will continue next week talking about the Holy Spirit. We have the armor of God. We also have another helper, the Holy Spirit. It's very important, the Holy Spirit. We talk about Jesus and the Father, but we need the Holy Spirit to help us. When you depend on the Holy Spirit, it increases your power to fight against the giants. So we need the Holy Spirit. So next week, we'll talk about the Holy Spirit. Okay. I'm going to close right now with prayer. God in heaven, Lord, we come before you, Lord. As we know, we slay the giants and they will come again. So I ask you to help us, be with us. Help us not to become lazy. Help us become strong. Help us support each other so we grow in you. Our defense increases. As we know, we depend on you. Help us remember that it's all about you. It is you that gives us power. It is you that defeats the giant. I thank you for that, for being with us all. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Are any of you facing any giants right now? You could come up and I'll pray for you. If you have any